Okay, hello, this is part I think 3 of our tutorial. We're making this scene here, and let's start by adding in this guardrail here. So since we already have this small one, we can just use that as a starting point. Let me just duplicate this and bring that in. We can go to edit mode and start changing a few things here. First I'm just going to remove this solidify modifier. Maybe let me first disable this, and we can start off. So this is a bit thick, this top rail here, so I can even just delete the entire thing and just add a play in edit mode. Okay, this 90 degrees scale on the X. I think this would be this kind of form. That, yes, shade smooth. Now we have something like that. We can give this a metal material like that. It's going to make this less rough by adding a math node there, something like that. Can borrow the same thing, shift D, rotate 90 degrees. Let's see how thick are these balls. Are they not really, they're the same thickness, but they are rotated like this. And instead of using UV mapping, I can use object mapping here to make my life much easier. And I think this is going to be a bit smaller than that. So let's bring that in. Something like that. Can bring in the array. Okay, let me make this a bit smaller and bring that closer there. Let's go back to the world settings here and just have a look at a few things. It's going to reduce the strength. Play with everything like that. Let me make these windows glass. Okay, have this disabled, so let me just go back to that. Where is that? Scar. want this to render as a silhouette, but I think the lighting from this sky is coming in from all directions. That's why you see that we're not seeing it as a silhouette, but I'll find a way to just make it a bit darker here so that let's look back here. We have some volumetrics going on, so let's see if we can add that. Scale this. Going to change this to wireframe, scale that down, and give this a volumetrics. So just shade our principal volume, connect this to the volume 0.001, and increase the thickness a bit, maybe bring this down a bit, can even make it a bit emissive. By increasing the black body intensity here, it should give us, it should make it a bit just use emissiveness here to just get the colors I want. I'm just going to reduce the intensity here to something like 0.001, and you can see now we're getting that silhouette effect as we wanted. Now maybe let me reduce the intensity of the emission here. So see, and you can see from a far distance there is another level of maybe haze or something. Let me just duplicate that of this to the far distance. Let's scale it on the x-axis. Make sure it has a different material, and I'm just going to increase the emission value here until I can see this. So let me first increase the value of this. Let me see if I can see it. Okay, for some reason it's not rendering. But it's only rendering in different areas. Let's see why. So we have this, should be a bit lower than this. So we have that level, and we should also have, let me see if we go to volumetrics, see if this is affecting it. So if you're not seeing the volumetrics, it might be because it's being clipped off by your end value here. So I'm just going to reduce the density here, and get the strength down as well. Let's see. see. Okay, we want this kind of yellowish value there. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use an RGB node to fit this into the color and the emission color, so that I can only change, so that I just change one value like this. Just bring that down. Reduce the intensity. Bring it down even further. See if I hide this. This is the pink one. I also wanted to have an RGB that controls the color and the emission. There is a hash line here, so let's see if I use a gradient map here. Let's see, I can use texture coordinate mapping. So if I go under convert, I can separate I don't want this harsh transition, so I just want a more gradual transition instead of that harsh transition. So I'm going to create a mask for this. So let me first go back to that and just change this to textured. And let's look at this here for a second without the volume. I want the Z value. Scale it up so that we have a more we want a transition, so I can just add a math node here, operation of power, so that I can control the transition there. If I use this for the density, you can see what we have. This is going to be wire. I can clamp this using the car ramp. That so that let me actually look at this and see. So we want this to be flipped around, so I'll just flip this around and first we can add the power node just around there, so we can control how much of this works. This is the control I wanted, and now that we have that, we just feed this directly into the emission value here. Bring this up, you can see now we have a nice kind of sunset effect. Just have this spread. Now we can layer this and hide the other one. Just duplicate this and see now we have this as a separate layer in the back, but I want it to have a different color, so I'll just change that accordingly. Let's see what we have here. There are quite a few layers to work with here. Let's reduce the emissiveness of this, or the behind one. So we have this kind of yellowish color. We have this, have this, and then we have this kind of reddish version here. So I'm just going to bring that. Bring that in. Let's see if we can get something. Okay, now the resolution of your volumetrics is going to matter quite a lot here, so let's try adjusting that in the volumetrics here, down on volume shadows and under samples here. Let's try increasing that. And just get rid of this third one because it's creating a few issues. And duplicate a few lights here. Okay, I'll continue from there in the next video.